What's up, y'all? My name is Kendra, but you can call me Kenny. And in today's video, you will be seeing how I got this look using Nadula hair. In this video, I will be unboxing, customizing, installing, and styling this wig. So if you're interested in seeing how I achieved this look, then just keep watching. All right, so when you first get your package, this is how it comes. They give you a nude wig cap. They give you a bag of goodies, and in the bag, it comes with a box of earrings, a rat tail comb, a pair of lashes, and of course your wig. So I just wanted to show y'all the construction of the wig. It does come with two combs on the side, a comb in the back, the adjustable strap, but I don't end up using the two combs. I always cut them out and I do leave the one in the back for security. I did want to zoom in and show y'all that the knots did not come pre-bleached, so I will be bleaching those. The hairline is slightly pre-plucked, but I will be going in more to give it a more customized look. I did want to quickly come on here and show you guys what I'll be using to bleach my knots today. I will be using some Quick Blue Bleach by L'Oreal, some 40 Volume Developer, have a mixing bowl and brush, some foil strips. I place these inside the lace. Once I place the bleach, the foil just helps the bleach process faster, and then some gloves for safety. I did use two scoops of bleach, and then for the developer, I just kept pouring it until it got to the consistency that I like. I normally like it to be kind of like toothpaste. Place the foil strips inside the wig, like I said before, and then just flip the wig over so the bleach doesn't seep down onto the wig and over bleach your knots. So I did want to also show you what I'll be using to pluck my unit today. I will be going in and using some Tweezerman tweezers. I have just some regular slanted Tweezerman tweezers. I also use spritz. Now I use the spritz to spray on the front of the hairline, and then I'll follow that with the hot comb just to press the hair completely back so I can see exactly what needs to be plucked out. I do actually like to push all the hair back before I pull out the baby hair, which is what I'm doing now. I do this just because sometimes, not in this particular video, but sometimes I do take the wig off at this point and just measure it up to see if where the baby hair is out on the wig actually match up to where I will actually pull my real baby hair out at. You just want to hot comb the baby hair forward so they can be out the way, because you don't want your baby hair to be the hair that you pluck out once you go in and pluck the wig. So now I'm just going in and I'm thinning out the hair. So now you just want to hot comb your baby hair back in place so you can see exactly what's going on. And then I personally went in and plucked just a little bit more, just because I like that more defined hairline look, and I just think it looks more natural this way. All right, so now we're all done with the plucking, and this is how much hair that came out. Okay, so obviously I did my ball cap method off camera, but I do want to tell you what I used. So I went in with this stocking cap, and then I used the Ruby Kisses cream foundation. I used shade 12, and then I used shade 14. Now, I used two different shades because shade 12 has my actual face color in this palette. So this is the one I use for the actual lace. The shade 14, I use that on the cap because you always want your cap to be a little bit darker so it can be camouflaged underneath the lace. Oh, so I did want to come on here and tell y'all what I used to tone the knots and the hair. I did use two different purple shampoos. I used Shimmer Light shampoo on the knots, because if y'all know anything about Shimmer Lights, Shimmer Lights is thick and it's pigmented, I should say. Like, sometimes when I use it, it literally stained my nails. And if you use it on blonde hair and if it stays on too long, it can turn the hair purple. I don't like using it on my hair because I don't be wanting my blondes to have a purple tint to it if that's not the look I'm going for. But it's good to use on the lace because sometimes the knots can be very brassy. And so Shimmer Lights is good for that because the pigmentation in the shampoo tones out the knots perfectly. So I go in with the Ion Color Solution Shampoo. This shampoo is that girl. So the reason why I like using the Ion Color Solution Purple Shampoo is because the consistency is different. It's more watery than Shimmer Lights, but it tones the hair perfectly and it gives it like this metallic-y, shiny feel to the hair. And we always love something like that. So I use this for the hair, this for the knots. So enough about that, let's get into the next step. Okay, so now that we have the wig on, I am about to just try to match it up with my hairline as close as possible, and then I'm gonna cut the ear tabs off, and then once I do that, I'll further explain what's next. Okay, so now that I have my ear tabs cut off, I'm about to go in and cut the lace in sections. Now, I cut the lace in sections and also cut the lace off before I glue the wig down because I feel like this gives you a better chance to get the lace more close to your natural hairline as possible. Once I get done cutting the lace, I'll come back and show you what's next. I don't know if you guys can see, but I can see where my cap ends, which means that's where my hairline is technically at. So I just went in and pulled out a little bit of hair because I could clearly see that it's coming down too far. I also plucked a little bit just to create a little bit more gap. So once I do cut off the lace, it just won't look straight up like hair. It will go from lace to hair, if that makes sense. So now that we got the lace cut off, it's time to glue the wig down. But before we glue the wig down, we have to prep our skin. I normally go in with 91% alcohol and a cotton ball just to get the forehead free of any makeup and oils so we can have the best hold with the glue. And then I go in with the Hold Me Down Skin Guard by Erica J. I do use the watermelon scent just because I personally feel like the original Hold Me Down Skin Guard, the scent is just too strong. Like, I just can't get with it. So I recommend getting the watermelon scent just because it's better. And then to glue the actual wig down, I'm gonna go in with the original Erica J Hold Me Down adhesive. I'm gonna apply 3 layers of that, and once I'm done applying the layers, I'm going to tack down the wig and go sit under the dryer. Once I'm done with all that, I'll come back and wrap with y'all. All right, so this is me straight from under the dryer. I did sit under the dryer for about 15 minutes, so now let's just get into the styling. I did end up just deciding to go with the side part, but I didn't like that I couldn't see the actual part. I just think it's because the color of the wig was so close to my skin tone that nothing was defined, like especially the part. So I'm about to just go in and flatten out the wig so I can see exactly where the part is to define the wig a little bit more. I just went in with the wax stick to make the top a little bit more flat because I wanted the volume to be more so in the actual hair and not like straight from the scalp. Now I'm just pulling out some baby hair. I'm gonna hot comb the baby hair forward so they can kind of lay in the direction that I want them to, so it'll be easier to style them. Just trimming them to my desired length. Now I'm just gonna pluck them to thin them out so they can look a little bit more natural. Then I am gonna go in with this pencil thin flat iron just to curl the baby hair. Then I'm gonna spray some Got to Be glue on them so they can stay in place, but also give me that fluffy baby hair look.
Steady calling my phone. I told you before that it's over. Leave me alone. No, it's where you been no more. Make it where my dream no more. We ain't not a thing, can't take no more. But you know you can't, but wait some more. Yeah, I remember days when I used to adore. Funny how this shit just flipped like a coin. Get a new thing, I'm a Fendi in the yard. Get a new swing, I be talking about a phone. Steady calling my phone.
So I am taking a wax stick and just going through and hot combing again. Girl, I might hot comb a few more times. You can never hot comb too much. Like, you have to make sure that wig is flat, make sure it's looking natural, make sure it's not giving wig. And then I also went in with some root touch-up just to give it like a shadow root effect, so it can make the part more defined once I go in and conceal the part. So now you just want to take a baby hair brush and blend out the root touch up just so everything can be seamless and it won't look out of place. Now I'm just going in with some mousse, and I'm also going in with some bio silk to just make the hair look a little bit more glossy and give it a little bit more definition. I am going in with a diffuser, and I just went in with a diffuser simply just because I didn't want to wait for my hair to dry. I ended up cutting the hair a little bit, giving it a little bit of layer so it can have a little bit more body. So as you've seen in the beginning of the video, this is the final look, and I just want to say I am in love with how this turned out. I am in love with the color. I'm in love with the curl. I'm in love with everything. The only thing that I didn't like about this wig is the lace, and that's just because I feel like it was just a little bit too brown. But I ain't gonna lie, I finessed the hell out of this lace. I think it's cute. I like it a lot. And if you like it, you should give it a thumbs up. And until next time, bye.